since the discovery of penicillin several decades ago, antibiotics have really formed the cornerstone of modern medicine. We use them every day. We use them for a wide variety of infectious diseases, everything from strep throat to bloodstream infections to meningitis. What we are facing with increasing rates of resistance is that this cornerstone that we rely on is no longer reliable, that we more and more will face the possibility of untreatable bacterial infection, that we just don't have the right medicine to treat. We are trying to address it in a variety of projects. Burns patients typically, because they have lost their normal skin defenses, they spend often weeks in hospital, are more likely to become colonized with and develop infections from multi-drug resistant bacterial infections. The Peshawar project in Pakistan, this is focusing on neonates, babies less than 28 days old. In these babies, we are seeing multi-drug resistant pathogens. We think that the babies have acquired these infections from their mothers during the birth process. We see high rates of resistance in our reconstructive surgical program in Jordan. And this program looks after patients from the neighboring countries, from Iraq, Syria, Yemen, who have often had multiple surgeries and have received courses of various antibiotics before coming to us. The types of bacterial resistance that we are seeing in places like the Middle East really comparable to types of resistance that we are seeing in transplant units in wealthy countries in the United States. The World Health Organization released a surveillance report in 2014, which was really looking at available data or information from different parts of the world. And it really highlighted the fact that everywhere that antibiotic resistance has been looked for, it's found in alarming rates. And certainly in wealthy countries where health systems are more stable and more developed, there is more ability to address this issue head on. In poorer countries where health systems are not quite as developed, it can be extremely challenging. Within MSF, we appreciate that this issue is not going to go away and that to address it will be a long-term, enormous undertaking. But it is a challenge that we are already starting to address and will continue to in the coming years.